the line. What is it? And where do you draw it? 2018 was an incredibly difficult year for the line. It was electrocuted by YouTubers. Washed away by teens trying to make a meme real.
No!
And left on the passenger seat. With plenty of people not realizing they were crossing the line until they did, the line was pretty hard to pin down. Gender reveal parties burned their line into federal court when an off-duty Border Patrol agent pleaded guilty to starting a wildfire. Elon Musk submerged himself way beneath the line of baseless allegations when he accused one of the men who worked on rescuing a Thai soccer team of being a pedophile. Then he made his investors paranoid by blazing the line. Kanye West seemed to be keeping up with the line until April, when he started tweeting again. The all-new, red-pilled, MAGA hat-wearing, Dragon Energy Kanye might have crossed the line of admiration for his left-leaning fans, but the new, free-thinking Kanye found plenty of new fans on the other side of the line.
I love this guy right here. Yeah.
Tech companies struggled with where to draw the line for Alex Jones in InfoWars. Twitter put him on a timeout like a small child, so did Facebook, and YouTube tried a three-strike system. But then Apple pulled the InfoWars podcast offline, and everyone else realized exactly where the line always was. Wherever Apple says it is. Facebook spent the year either acting like it had nothing to do with the line or apologizing profusely for breaching the line of customer privacy. But all the hashtag delete Facebook outrage apparently resulted in was its users migrating to WhatsApp and Instagram, two companies owned by Facebook. Which should be enough to answer Lindsey Graham's line of inquiry.
You don't think you have a monopoly?
It certainly doesn't feel like that to me.
Some lines from Kevin Hart's past came back to remind him he crossed them about 7 or 8 years ago, when he made some homophobic jokes on Twitter, leading him to step down from his gig hosting next year's Oscars. Hart wasn't the only one to cross a predated line. James Gunn's old attempts at edgy jokes about rape and pedophilia cost him his gig directing the next Guardians of the Galaxy film. Roseanne Barr ambient tweeted herself over the line, insulting a former Obama advisor, and got her show cancelled, despite her impassioned defense.
I thought the bitch was white!
The First Lady wore the line on her way to visit migrant children separated from their families, later saying that it was intended as a message, which she explained with childlike wonder.
I wore the jacket to go on the plane and off the plane.
Gritty skated the rare positive line into the internet's heart and was saved from being claimed by the alt-right by first being claimed by Antifa. And Kim Jong-un did it. He literally crossed the line, proving there's nothing the great leader can't do. So if you're wondering whether that video you're about to post of your patently racist gender reveal, where laundry detergent pods filled with blue ink explode all over the Holocaust memorial, you don't need me to tell you where the line is. I guess the best way to keep on the right side of the line in 2019 would be if everyone made a concerted effort to be better people, not be racist, sexist, or homophobic, and stop endangering themselves or each other, even if it's all in the pursuit of the noble goal of going viral. Or you could just not tweet, I guess. That could also be your takeaway from all this.